Hello friends, welcome to part 2 of the video series on next word prediction algorithm using Markov chain written in Python. In the last video, I've shown you a working example of a Python algorithm, Python program, which can predict the next word user is going to type based on a training data that has been supplied to it. The video link is given in the description. In that video, I've taken you through all the variables, all the code, and in this video, I'm going to take you through the theoretical part, how this all system works. Before I take you through this process, let me give you a very quick demo of the same application. Let me type next word prediction and I'll say I. It is going to suggest me what I would like to type. Say I would like to type like only. Let me press tab to accept it. Then it says I can type either ML or reading. Let me take reading. And it says that I like reading. And after like reading, I should type either book or ML, though I can type anything on my own as well. But this is something on which the system has been trained. So let me take ML. So it says it is now done. All the training has been exhausted, and this is what the recommendation engine is. So for Markov chain explanation, you would like to create a state diagram and a transition probability matrix TP. For a state diagram, you will identify all the possible states where the data can flow. Let me take you through this. In this presentation, in the bottom, you can see what is the training data. For the sake of simplicity, I've taken only three sentences. Do you like reading ML? I like ML books. I like reading books. There, individual word is taken as a feature. Do you like reading ML? And based on whatever, suppose user types do, then system is going to suggest you. But how it is going to do, for that we are going to first define the states. So let us see when user starts. First let us take assumption that user is not going to type anything apart from whatever it has been trained on. If user types anything else, then system is not going to predict anything for him. User will not give any suggestions to the user, right? So we'll go for a positive test case only. So let us see the first word. The first word in these three training sentences is do or I, correct? So do and I. So the probability will get divided between the two, right? This is a mistake. Why this probability is divided between 0.3 and 0.7? Because do has come only once out of three sentences, and why it is 7? It is 2 out of 3. 2 by 3, 0.667. So this is how probability is getting calculated. So now you have got an idea of how further probabilities will get calculated. In this working example, if you see my spider screen, I have already cached my variables. So for do, it calculated 0.33, and for I, it calculated 0.66. What this code is, how this probability is getting calculated, what are these variables and all that stuff, for that you can refer my previous video. Now let us go back to the flow, right? So after I and do, we have detected our first word. After I and do, we'll take the easy example first. The do you. After do, there is only one probability. Only you can come. You can see you do is nowhere else in these sentences, right? So the probability of you is 1, that is 100%. But now we have got second word, but it is not complete because I is still pending. For I, it will be like, because in both cases the sentence is like. So the probability of like after I is again 100%. So we have got our second word as well. Now there is a time for the transitions. The first word, second word, and the transitions. These are the three dictionaries that have been maintained by the program. You can see here on the top, first possible word, second possible words, and the transitions. So let us go to the dictionary. After you, do you like. You can say do you. After do you, there is nowhere else do you there in the training data. So probability of coming like after do you is 100% again. Do you, then probability of like is 100%. And same way, if I go for like, you like reading. It is again 100% because you word is nowhere else except this statement. So you like reading will again, the probability will be 100%. Right. Now we'll take the next state from like reading. What can come after like reading? It is ML. Like reading. Is it, let us see, it is 0.5. There is a catch here. Why after like reading ML is coming 50%? Because you can see in other sentence like reading books is also coming in some other sentence. The probability will get divided as a 50% between like reading books or like reading ML. Same way we'll create the state diagram for other possible. For example, I like ML. I like ML. After I like, there is no ML, so probability is 100%. And like ML, so the probability is 50%. Like ML reading, I like reading, I like reading, or I like ML, I like ML, right? So this is the state diagram that should be created. Why it is being created and the benefit, I'll show you in the further slides. So we'll, let us finish this state diagram, which is almost finished now. So we have created the transitions connecting end to the start, because we need to complete the probability, and this is just for the demonstration purposes. Right, now let us create the probability matrix. So this is the probability matrix. Let me explain this probability matrix. This transition probability matrix, you can see it is a same dimensions matrix at the both ends. The states are whatever the possible states exist in the state diagram on rows and on columns. But the point is, this one is current state and this one is your next state. For example, if I start, then after start to end, it will be zero probability. After start from the current state, the probability of getting either do or I is 50-50. Let me correct it again. So do was 33% and it was 0.67%. Start to end is 33 and 67. After that, there is nothing. There is one rule, another rule for this matrix is sum of total probability for each current state should be 1. So 0.33 plus 0.67 after start becomes 1. So everything else will be 0. As you can see, after start, only two possible states can emerge here, right? There is no other state. That is what the point. Only possible state was do you. So I put a 100% probability here as do you. Same way I like. The state is 1. After that, I put a 1. Let me elaborate one or two columns more. After do you, what was the state? Do you. After that, the maximum probability was 100% for like. So let us put the same do you like. You like. So we have put 100% here. So we'll finish this matrix in the same way for the start and end. After adding this, the matrix becomes 11 by 11. Why we have created this matrix? This is important. To explain this, we have to do some maths. Let me put this matrix in front of you so that you can come to this screen again and visualize this if you need. So I'm keeping my screen frozen here for a few seconds so that if you want to come here and verify the numbers, you can. After that, move on to the next slide. Now let us go to what Markov chain is, why we have created this matrix and all. Though we have created here after I like ML, we have already done the coding, and for our use case, this two state matrix, two generation matrix is enough. Based on that, we are able to easily identify what is the third word user can predict. But Markov chain is applicable to many other places. So for that, you need to understand the math behind it, how a next generation word can be identified, right? So how a next generation word can be identified, or next generation state can be identified, is it is a matrix multiplication of probability matrix multiplied by the current state. To explain it further, I'll take one example. For example, if user types like you, after suppose user has typed like and then he types like you like, let us see what is the state. You like, so after you like, it is 100% it would be reading, but we have to derive it using maths, right? So we'll put this you like in a matrix form, that will be 1-to-1 matrix. I put zeros everywhere, and where it was like, I put 1. Let us see where it was. It is at the fifth number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, correct? So it was like. Like is at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like as a fifth position, right? You like. Now put a 1 here. Now I multiplied this matrix, complete matrix, with this matrix, and what I've got result, I got is a 1 at position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 position. Let's see what there is 6 position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 reading, and what we expected is reading. Proven. Let us take some more examples. Then I'm using NumPy for this. I put this matrix already in a variable m, right? And I've done some examples. Now I'm using numpy dot matmul matrix multiplication. So matrix, our probability matrix, transition probability matrix, is multiplied with the current state that user is going to type. For example, user types reading. So let us put the reading. Where is reading? Here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is at the sixth position, right? So we'll put 1 for the sixth position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we'll put 0 everywhere. So it says I'm going to have two 50-50% probabilities. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. At 7th and 8th position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it says either ML or books. If user says reading, then there are probability that it is going to either type ML or the books. Let us verify it. The same thing in the state diagram. After reading, it is going to type either books or the ML. 50-50. Right. So by this, we can derive the next state. And so now, based on a dictionary or a probability matrix and what user has typed, now computer can suggest, your system can suggest what is the next word user can type. I hope this is exciting, and you can find multiple applications using Markov chains. You can subscribe to the channel if you want to keep yourself updated with upcoming videos, and press bell icon if you want to get notified of the upcoming videos. The code has already been put on the GitHub, which is the location of the GitHub repository is mentioned in the code. For any comments, you can give me a comment. I'll reply.